Yeah. 22 verses 6. Amen. And it reads, I will bless God every chance I get. My lungs expand with praise. I live and breathe God. If things aren't going well, hear this and be happy. In verse 6 it says, when I was desperate, I called out, and God got me out of a tight spot. And here in the text, I want to kind of help us along the way. Here in the text, David promises to persistently praise God. And the word persistently means enduring, lasting, and especially in spite of. It's a constant repeating or a continued action. And it should be understood that David is not promising a marathon praise session, but rather is committing himself to the praise of God at every opportunity. And in the midst of various states of mind and spirit and body, just as the Bible tells us to pray without ceasing, in 1 Thessalonians 5 and 17, we have to pray consistently and in all circumstances. So here David just promising to praise without ceasing. I want you to high five your neighbor and tell your neighbor, say, I still gotta pray. That might not be the right neighbor, because somebody might not understand what you're going through, right? But you can high five the one next to you and tell them, I still gotta pray. And in the past year, ever since we came into December, we talked about seeing more, and we've been blessed throughout the whole year. But we've been through a lot since the beginning of this year. I mean, some spiritual things have been going on in our mind. We had some financial things going on in our homes, in our jobs. We've had some personal things we've been dealing with. We've been dealing with some issues. We've had some sickness. We've had some illness. We had some loss of a family member. We've been going through a lot since the beginning of 2017. But I thank God that we still have been persistent, moving right along about God's business. I mean, we've had some changes in our situations. Hospital stays, dealing with racial equality, inequality, injustice, dysfunctional leadership. But even in the midst of all this, I do believe we still gotta pray. In the midst of all that is going on, that's been going on in our lives, I believe there's something inside of us that still knows that God is good. It is something that's deep down inside of you, because you know God has made a way out of no way. Although I just may be talking to myself this morning, but I just do believe that I got some folk in St. Paul this morning that can testify without a doubt that it's still God praise. And see, when you say that you still God praise, you're talking about that. You know something, even though I'm dealing with some issues, I still can give God some glory. Even though I'm dealing with some things in my life, I still can praise God. I know somebody up in here that can high five their neighbor and tell their neighbor, yeah, I've been dealing with some things, but God is still the good. Do I have any folk up in St. Paul this morning that can understand that you still got to praise, that you still can give God some glory, even in spite of? I know you can testify to somebody and say, I almost lost my mind, but God kept me. I almost lost my job, but God kept me. I almost turned up on somebody the other day, but God kept me. In spite of, you still can tell somebody, I gotta praise. I got to give God some glory. You dealing with sickness in the body, but you know that God kept you. You hear pastor talking about all the hospital visits and all the things that people are going through, but they know that God still is able. And I just do believe that it don't matter what we're dealing with or going through, that God still got our back. God still gonna make a way out of no way. God still gonna lift me up. God still gonna heal my body. And I just do believe that we have a praise on the inside of us. And David understood that. David understood that he was going to be attacked from all angles because of who he was. David understood that people was going to ridicule him because of what he stood for. But he still gave God praise, and he still gave God glory. And see, I don't know who I'm talking to here this morning, but I know that every time I'm dealing with some issues, I understand that God is about to bless me in a mighty way. Every time I'm going through something, I just have to shake it and shake my leg and realize that, you know something, God, even though I'm going through a situation right now, but you're about to give me something I've been asking you for. That's something that I've been praying for. See, we got to understand that we got to give God praise in all aspects of our life. I know I ain't caught up with you yet, but I'm about to catch up with some of you, because I know every now and then that when we get in our feelings, and when we feel a little uncomfortable, we like to just sit around and look all dumb in the face and bow for realizing that God ain't done that to you. But I was just telling my sister, I said, when I look out there over the crowd, I said, even though there ain't too many folk in here, folks still should be smiling because you've been blessed and highly favored. And here, in verse 1, David said, my lungs expand with praise, giving thanks to God for everything that I've been through, and everything that I'm going through, and even in the things that I'm about to go through. So David just realized that, you know, so I got to praise. The Bible says that let everything that has breath praise God. So no matter what you're going through, no matter what you're dealing with, as long as you're giving God praise, everything is going to be all right. So as long as you're breathing, you still got to give God praise. I mean, the doctor just diagnosed you with cancer, but you can say thank you, God. The doctor just said your diabetes been acting up, but you say thank you, God. The doctor just said that you might have 3 or 4 months to live, but you still can tell God thank you, because and see, I don't know about you, but as long as I have some breath in my body and the blood of Jesus running warm in my veins, I'm going to continue to give God praise. Because when I think about the goodness of Jesus, I realize that God has brought me from a mighty long way. And when I think about all that God has done for me in my life, every time I think about the goodness of Jesus and all he has done, my soul cries out, hallelujah. And every time you think about the goodness of Jesus, you should feel something that's burning deep down in your soul. You should feel this burning sensation down in your soul. And every time you think about the goodness of Jesus and all that God has done for you, that thing should be in your life. Fire is shut up in your bones, that you can't hold it. You just got to shout glory to God. It's something down in you that you just can't hold it in you. You start to shout and run around like David. And next thing you know, you're running around here with all your clothes off. And folk don't understand your praise. See, ain't nobody gonna understand your praise because they don't understand where you come from. Folk don't understand your praise because they don't understand what you've been through. Folk ain't gonna understand your praise because they don't understand what God has brought you through. So that's why they look at you funny. That's why they look at you in these awkward ways when you shout to Jesus and when you're catching the Holy Ghost. Folk don't understand your praise. But it says when you get to a point in your life when you start to understand, you know something, it don't matter what I've been through, it don't matter what I'm going through, it don't matter what I'm dealing with, I still can give God glory. Because when I look back over my life, I realize what God has brought me from. To me. It's not just to believe because I'm looking over the audience. Some folk looking good out there. You're in your pink, you're in your nice shoes, your nice blazers, and your nice polo shirts, you're looking good.
All right.
But don't fool me, I just don't believe we always been this way. And so when I understand that I ain't always been in this spot that I'm in, I got to give God glory because I know someone can testify, you know something? I should have been dead and gone, but God got me still here. I should have died on the operating table, but God still got me here. I should have had this car wreck on the way here, but God helped me. And we still been giving praise and giving glory. See, this thing is about to get good. Every time when the Holy Spirit enters the building and makes folk do things they wouldn't normally do.
Right.
Amen. And they said, David said, you know, so I still got a praise.
Right.
He said, even though folk trying to kill me and write me off, I still got something inside of me that way I can tell God thank you. You know, it may not be all peaches and cream, but I can tell God thank you because I still got the opportunity to see another day.
All right.
And so I want you a little bit of favor. Look at your neighbor and say, you might want to give you a little bit of room. Because I'm starting to feel a little something right about that. You might want to give me a little bit of space because when I get to shouting and getting to praising God, I don't want this to hit you upside your head and then you be looking at me all crazy after the service. So you might want to give me some room because when I go to think about it, the goodness of Jesus and what God has done to me, I just want to shout. When you know my grandma used to say that every time I think about how I came from a one-room shack to a three-bedroom house, I just can give God glory. She used to say, I remember the days when I used to have to go 100 feet out into the outhouse just to use the restroom. Now I got some fresh plumbing in the house. I remember the days when I used to have to go to the well and pump a little water. Now I got some fresh water in the house. See, my grandma used to give him praise in spite of 16, 17 hour days in the cotton field. I still can give him the glory and give him the praise because you still kept me. And here, David does not dwell on his experience, nor even on his deliverance, but on his deliverer. See, he ain't thinking about how he got there. He just focused on who got him there. And see, that's what we got to understand. It don't matter how you get here. All you got to do is worry about that God got you here. Every time, I don't know how I get here. I know folks try to Google and look up on the thing and see where I come from and see what I've been through. But you got to understand, David, it don't matter what I went through with him. It don't matter how I got here. You need to be focused on the women that got me here because I do just believe that it's some folk in here that can understand that there was a raven that got you to the point that you are right about now. There's a deliverer that got you to the point that where you are now. There's an Alpha and Omega that got you to the point where you are now. And David said, he cried, he said, the Lord is both the subject and the object of my prayer. See, I like that right there. See, he ain't saying nothing about it with a little pooky or a little ring ring or Shaniqua. He didn't say nothing like no Mercedes. He said, the Lord is the object and the subject of my praise. So that means my Lord is the beginning and my end. And that's all it means. It don't matter what's going on around me. Now I still got to focus on Jesus. I know they're talking about me every day, but I still got to focus on Jesus. I know they're not doing the things they're supposed to be doing, but I still got to focus on Jesus.
Yes,
and David said, the Lord, you the subject and the object of my praise.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. He said, no matter all my trial and tribulation that I've been through, I go back to verse 2 and remind me that. In verse 2, when David said, you know, he said, I live and breathe God.
Yeah.
He said, if things aren't going well, he said, I'm still happy.
Uh-huh.
He said, if things ain't going the way I would like for them to go, he said, I'm still happy.
Uh-huh.
It reminds me that we should live and breathe God regardless of how things are going on.
That's right. Amen.
In our life.
Uh-huh.
Just the fact that he's giving you an opportunity, another chance of life, you got to praise him.
Amen.
Why we wouldn't praise a God like that?
Amen.
knowing how many times we don't mess up, knowing how many times we fall short, but God still supplies some grace and mercy over our life. Why would we serve? Why would we serve a God like that? I'm talking about a God that picked you up and turned you around and placed your feet on solid ground. Do I have any cancer survivors in the building? Huh? See, you ain't got to say this. All you have to do is just wave your hand out. See, you got some survivors. See, there's some folk in here that know about the goodness of Jesus. And they still got to praise in spite of. That good kingdom survivors can tell you that the road wasn't easy. But God is still good. God has still kept them. God has still blessed them. God has still delivered them. God has still put them back when folk had no room off. And so we still got to find something down inside of us that can give God praise and just give him some glory. I said, it makes me wonder, because we serve a God that's willing to do exceedingly abundantly above all things in our life, how can we not serve him? See, no matter what you're going through, no matter what it looks or how it seems, no matter how bad things get, you still got to give God some glory.
Amen.
And give God some praise.
Amen.
And here, David basically said, for God I live, and for God I die.
Amen.
And if you know what we studied in Samuel, he had to be true to his word because he was constantly trying to be killed. I don't know about you, but you may not be in the literary sense, but there's some things that's constantly trying to kill your spirit for Jesus. It's some people in your life that's constantly trying to kill your drive for Jesus. But you got to understand that it's for God you live and for God you die, because he's the one that gave you this life in the first place. And it says that when you have this praise, you start to think about, you know, so God, I wouldn't even be here if it had not been for you. And you start to say to yourself, Lord, where would I be if it had not been for you on my side? Yeah. Where would I be? I might not be where I want to be, but I thank God I ain't where I used to be. That's a good one right there. I might not be where I want to be, God, but I thank you, you ain't left me where I used to be. Do I have any witnesses up in St. Paul that testify, you know, so God, you've been good to me, and I thank God that I'm not where I used to be. I thank God that you brought me to a point where I am now. Do I have any folk up here just to give God a shout and give God a praise and give God a hallelujah that I'm your spirit? You ain't got to do much. All you got to do is give a little praise. And God is pleased. He says, David said, I can thank God I'm not where I used to be. And here in Romans in 5:3, it said that we should glory or be joyful in our tribulations.
Yeah.
We should be happy when we're going through our situations. See, I don't know about you, but every time I think about the goodness of Jesus, I got to give God praise. I got to smile. I got to tell him thank you. And when I'm in the comfort every now and then, I find myself shouting out hallelujah. And folks be looking at me like I've lost my mind. Because see, when I look back over my life, see, I ain't talking about nobody else. Like, I'm talking about when I look back over my life and realize where God has brought me from, I can't help but shout hallelujah. And see, I just know that, you know, the Bible says when praises go up, blessings go down, but also it says that when he was fighting the battle of Jericho, that on the seventh time that he was going around praising, they say that when they were praying, they went to praising so hard that the walls came tumbling down. So if y'all can help me, and we might get a little upset about this, because I just believe we can tear the roof on St. Paul and everybody starts to think back over their life. I thought everybody just started to take a glimpse and take a picture of the life that they had. And everybody started to look back and say, you know something, God? I got to give you praise, and I got to tell you thank you, because I realized that I wasn't nothing without you, but now that I'm in Jesus, I got a little something. And you look back on your life and realize, you know something, God? That I wasn't always the person I am today, but I can thank you, God, because I know I messed up, and I know I was torn up from the floor, but you decided He can replace that. But it says that we should glory and be joyful in our trials and tribulations. And when I think about how good God has been to me, I remember the things that he brought me through. It makes me just want to give him more of praise and more of glory. And how he brought me from a prison system to a pulpit system. I go out of a cold jail into a warm bed. Every time I think about the goodness of Jesus, I got to give him glory. So if y'all don't mind, if I got a few more that can help me praise God and set for his glory, that can help me lift him up, because if your God has been good to you, that you know God has made a way out of no way. You thought you would make it this morning, but God is still in the blessed business. Do I got some folk in St. Paul that can shout out, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, the Lord has been good to me. The Lord has been great to me. Ain't God good? Ain't he all right? You say that. You say that. And in verse 6, and I'm trying to feel something now, so y'all might want to move on out my way a little bit here. I was trying to feel a little something. And it says in verse 6 that his David says, when I was desperate, I called out to him, and God helped me out of a tight spot. And this just made me realize that David realized that praise still works. That praise still works. And as children of God, we have to realize that our praise and our prayer still works when it pertains to our God. It says no matter what you are going through or dealing with, that praise still works. And sometimes because of the things that we are going through, we tend to forget about praise. Because of the things that we're dealing with, we tend to let it get in the way of us giving God praise. And you know how we get over, oh, I just don't feel like going to church today. That day I had a rough night. That I can't sing in the choir today because you know that old devil just be on me. Well, I'm here to tell somebody this morning that if you know like I know, when you're dealing with the things and the difficulties of life, sometimes you just have to be like Joel down in the bed of the beast. Sometimes you got to be like Joel down in a difficult situation and give him praise and glory. Sometimes you got to be like Daniel in the lion's den and just start giving God some praise and giving God some glory. Sometimes you got to be like David on the backside of the mountain saying, you know, son, God, I need you in my life. Every now and then, when you get in a tight situation, you got to find some praise that's stuck up on the inside of you. And be like Jeremiah saying, you know, son, even though I'm going through, even though I'm dealing with, I know God is still able. And this thing is like fire that's shoved in my bones. And you don't believe him, want to go talk to your brother Job. Job had everything taken from him but his life. Even his own wife told him, said, you know something, you might as well give up and curse God. But Job said, oh no, because when I think about the goodness of Jesus and where God has brought me from, I still got to give him glory. And I still got to give him praise. For the Lord has been good to me. Do I got any folk that can testify? In spite of me not doing everything that I need to do, the Lord has been good to me. In spite of me not being all that I can be for Jesus, the Lord has been good to me. And they say, even when you're down in the bed of the beast, you have to praise your way through it. You know how we say, Lord, this might not be my best day, but I can thank God it's not my worst day. It ain't my best day. Lord, I might not be able to sing praises to you, but I can at home. See, Lord, I may not be able to get in a good note, but I can still sit in the corner like my mama used to sit up in the old Baptist church and give you a good home. I still can sit in the place, even when my mouth get all tied up and dried up. I still can sit in the corner and give you a good home. Uh-huh. Yeah. And grandma, she was the perfect example for you got to still have a praise on the inside. All right. See, my grandmother came up when that thing was real rough.
So you were about the 16, 17 hour day and come home and cook your dinner for Papa. Wake up 4 o'clock in the morning after 2 hours of sleep just to make some homemade biscuits for Papa. And still be to Sunday school and start at 8 on time. So me and my new wife, how praise God still works. And she used to always say, you know something, son, you gotta praise him in spite of. Even when I really didn't understand who God was, she always tell me that God is always good.
Amen.
And no matter what you're going through, you got to praise him.
Uh-huh.
See, that's why her favorite hymn was, she always say, pass me not, O gentle Savior.
Uh-huh.
Do not pass me by. And when I think about what Mima used to say and the things that she would try and steal to me, she was just saying, all you got to do is just praise God.
Yeah.
It don't matter how you look, what you wearing, or where you come from. He said, all you got to do is praise
him.
Uh-huh. All you got to do is get in the glory.
Amen.
And God will get you out of a bad situation.
Mm-hmm.
And God will do that just for you. Even when you're hurt, when you're lonely, when you're going through hell, and sometimes there's something down in your spirit that tells you you just got to give God praise.
Amen.
Because trouble don't last always. And David says, even when my flesh don't feel like it, I give God praise because I realize there's some folk out there that are more deserving than me.
Uh-huh.
But then I wake up this morning.
All right.
Is that anybody tell me? Uh-huh. You know there's some folk out there more deserving. You sitting up in chapel all this morning. You really didn't make it. You ain't always been on your best behavior tonight. You ain't always saying the right thing that came out your mouth. But you can thanks be to God that God has allowed enough grace and mercy in your life to allow you to sit before him this morning. He allows us to give praise and worship. He allows us to go through the vision of the ministry and the death. He allows all this thing all because of his grace and his mercy.
Uh-huh.
See, I don't need nobody fooling me because I know every time, every now and then we can just go through the motions. But God has been good.
Yes,
it is.
Amen.
And he said, because I realize some folk that deserve it were far better than me. See, praise don't brought you out of a bad day.
Mm-hmm.
Praise brought some joy in your heart.
Right.
Praise filled the broken and empty places.
Yeah.
In your body, in your mind, in your soul, in your soul. And in spite of the struggles, you can say, God, you're so God, I still got a friend.
Yeah.
I still can give God glory.
Amen. Uh-huh.
I still can shout.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
But see, I want to explain something to you. One of Satan's favorite schemes is to send something bad into your life and blame it on God. And see, if you can get the people to believe it is from the Lord, he has an easier time convincing them of his next life. That God has failed you and somehow deserted you. When you know in the word that God says, I never leave you, nor forsake you.
Right.
And then he'll follow this thing up with the father line. Why go on serving a God like that? Why go on serving a God that allows you to lose your job, allows you to lose your house and lose your car, and almost allows you to lose your mind? So basically what it tells me, Satan's real target is to destroy our faith in God. Because the Bible says faith is the substance of things to come. So long as I got my faith, I got some good stuff that's coming to me.
Amen.
See, I may be going through something right about now and dealing with some issues right about now. My body may be aching, but long as I got faith in the God that says he'll heal my body, then my body shall be healed.
Amen.
Long as I got some faith in the God that says, you know something? Yeah, I don't lost my job. I ain't got no money in the bank, but my God says he'll supply all my needs. I got some food in the refrigerator. I got some water on the floor. I got some things in my life that God has already supplied because of my faith.
Amen.
And so here, the devil is trying to destroy your faith. And sometimes we get caught up and don't understand the same way. The devil just been on the why. The devil attacking me. Why ain't doing this and why ain't doing it? Why ain't doing that? Well, maybe it ain't the devil that's attacking you. Oh, my bad, I'm helping with you to understand. Maybe it's the devil that's attacking you, but you know that God allowed the devil to attack you, because don't let happen on this earth unless God allowed it to happen. So he may just be allowing the devil to mess with you for a little bit. It's called like a faith check.
All right.
You know that one day, you know where you ever been somewhere where everybody all holy in the God and they all giving God glory because everything going good in their life. So what God does say, you know something? I need to find out who really down with me. You know you don't have some friends that say they're up and down with you like four flats and they're gonna be there for you, they're gonna be here for you. But soon as you try to call them, or soon as you're gonna give them a message on Facebook and Instagram, you and they ain't know how to be found. I see y'all putting on Facebook all the time. But tell some people that I said call and y'all put a name in bold letters. So God just sends out a faith check to find out who really down with it and who really not. Because see, I can give God all the glory and praise when everything going great in my life. When everything is hunky dirty, when everything is peachy and cream. But will I be able to give God some glory when I lost everything that I had? When the devil has, that he allowed the devil to take everything he's got, which is just don't kill him. Do I want to give God some praise when the doctor has diagnosed me with cancer and say I don't have but a few months to live? Will I still glorify God? Will I still give him some glory? Praise. Uh-huh. So for those who are going through this, just understand it's just a faith check from God. Uh-huh. It ain't gonna kill you. It's just a faith check from God. Uh-huh. But I gotta tell you a story before I get up out of here. Because I do believe that the way this thing works is that I myself, I gotta continue to give God praise. Because God said, you know something, what you... I'm working on the inside, but you still a little rough around the edges. And he said, you know, and I was always asking, say, God, you know, why you got to still leave me rough around the edges? He said, I got to leave you different from everybody else. And see, because all of them don't know that all of us are different in our own special way. Yeah. Uh-huh. We are all tailor-made. That's why nobody can't understand. And that's why sometimes the person next to you can't understand just who you are, because you tailor-made. And so here, I was asked a question. I was having a conversation with somebody and asked a question. They said, well, you know, how can your faith be so strong in God when all that you've gone through and continue to go through? And they said, yes, and I said continue. Because they said, well, I know how you're constantly under attack. And I got quiet for a minute. And I was like, man, you don't Google me again? And so, see how your faith can be so strong. And I tell them, I say, you know something? No matter how much it hurts, no matter how much I got to deal with, I still find some way to give God praise and glory. And the reason I find a way to give Him praise and glory is because a room, a one-room shack is better than a 6x8 jail cell. Some beans and wings.
All right.
It's better than what you fed me now. Uh-huh. And so they go and ask and say, well, if God don't cross by it, why He continue to let you go through it? I say the reason He continued to allow me to go through it, I say, because He need to make sure that I remember where I come from. And so he said, what you mean, remember where you come from? So you from Buller Avenue? I said, no, I'm from Armstrong. One road in and one road out. And I heard the God in Christ say, what good to come out of Armstrong Road? And so I found myself looking in the mirror. So then the conversation went a little deeper. And he said that, do you ever wish you were back in the world? I say, what part of the world? Because I wanted to know what he was talking about. He said, well, you ever went back and doing this stuff we used to? And I said, you know something? I see folk now doing the things I used to do. Uh-huh. I say, but when I look back over my life, I still can't
can't find myself in a mindset where I can say, you know something, I want to be back in that life because that life was greater than this life. I told somebody one time, I said, you know something, I invested 33 years in the world and ain't getting nothing in return. In the last 7 or 8 years, I've been invested in God. I don't got double my portion. See, I'm talking to somebody this morning, see, but somebody ain't feeling what I'm saying. See, you ain't got to worry about what folk think about it, what folk think of you, and why you going through this, and why you going through that. We just have to understand that God has a plan for our life. And through the midst and through it all, that we still have to give God glory and give God praise. And so I stopped by St. Paul this morning to let somebody know over here that even though you're going through something in your life, or that you're dealing with a situation in your life, or your money looking funny, your family acting up, or your kids acting like they don't want to give you the respect that's due, that you still can praise God. You still can give God glory and tell God thank you. You are having witnesses up in St. Paul this morning that can testify and that can tell God thank you. Because you know you woke up with the wrong plan or on your share his word. I share just one of my testimonies because I want people to understand that the God we serve is real.
All right.
For those of you who don't know, I've been going through a transition process. You know, coming from being a pastor of a church for nearly 4 years to coming back to serve under my pastor, my mentor, my friend, and it has not been an easy transition. But when I spoke to God, God said, "You know something? I got you moving through this land for a reason." And so I asked, I said, "Well, God, what you want me to do while I'm in this land?" I said, "Cause I really don't feel I have a place." And he said, "What I want you to do is, in spite of what's going on, I need you to give me some glory and give me some praise right now." He said, "But in the midst of all that, when you finish," he said, "every chance you get, I need you to allow me to use you to the fullest." And the reason I'm sharing that with you, because see, folk don't understand why you praise God. And so I'm gonna tell you another one of my testimonies of why I praise God. Because see, all folk know is what they Google. And all it says is, he's been the inmate of DOC. That's all it says. But it don't go into details. But I want to share something to you why I praise God, and I would encourage you to give God praise in spite of. See, folks think that life is just what it is. But I remember back in 2001, I went down south to do a deal. And we were all in the house. We were waiting, because we had said everything, we were waiting on everything to come through. But as we were waiting, two guys busted in the back door with ski masks on, made us all get on our knees. And they were standing behind us, execution style. And I can hear them as they're coming down, but we were so shook and so shocked we couldn't really turn. We weren't trying to move, we were just sitting there on our knees. And one of my father's pills, one of them, he hit side of his head. I remember the other one, he hit him side of his head. And when he got to me, he didn't even know me, I didn't know him. He said, "You got to go." And I felt the barrel of the gun on the back of my head. And he pulled the trigger. And it didn't go off. And when that happened, I heard somebody yelling, "The folk were coming," and they ran back out the back door. But I didn't understand what the gist of that would be, because my cousin just went through the same situation. And he didn't make it. So what I'm telling you is, I have no choice but to give God praise and give it glory. Because the life that I'm living now, it don't belong to me. It belongs to God. And some folks out there talking about God ain't real. I've been to a lot of places. I know good well it was God that stopped that glory from going off. I'm not dumb enough. I'm not that dumb. I'm smart enough to know that it was God that didn't allow that gun to go off. He said, "I'll let you try, but I can't let you get it." So, as we stand to our feet, God's speaking to somebody this morning. Because whatever you've been dealing with in your life, whatever you've been going through, you think, oh, it's just me. But you got to understand that we all go through it. And the only one that can see you through it is God.